Good evening, I'm Ruth Fernandez with News Daily. We bring you the latest updates on the disturbing incident that has shaken our community. Earlier today, in the residential neighborhood at Papadda, a violent stabbing took place. The victim, Mr. John, was rushed to the hospital and in critical condition. Authorities have launched an investigation into the matter and have identified the suspect responsible for this heinous act. We can confirm that the suspect is currently in police custody. Stay tuned for the latest updates. This is Ruth Fernandez reporting for News 8.
Doctor, what happened?
I forgot what happened. I'm so sorry.
What am I even gonna do? I'm a failure. I failed him. I failed his entire family. Did you know? His wife is with child. I don't have the courage to tell her that a child is not going to see her, his father.
What's so sad about getting paid anyway for it, right?
Pull myself together? Do you know what's it like to lose a patient on the table, knowing the only chance of survival was a transplant? We couldn't provide.
Doctor, listen. You know we tried everything we could. There's nothing we can do about it now.
We were supposed to save a life, not let it define our shortcomings.
You yourself know that pancreatic transplants are rare and difficult. We couldn't avoid this.
Don't you dare. Don't you dare stand there and defend our failure. You see, that patient, he trusted us. And we let them down.
Doctor, listen. We are only humans, not medical workers. We couldn't change the outcome, no matter how hard we tried.
Well, maybe to you, it's okay to separate a child from his father, a father from his child, but I'm a doctor. And I became one to save lives. And not watch it be the reason why our shortcomings slip away into realities.
Apparently, one of them has already slipped away.
Excuse me?
You've handled so many cases before. You must be out of your mind.
I have to save him.
Doctor, you are losing it.
I have to save it! This is absurd. We have to get this to the notice of the dean.
You can't just barge in here. What is wrong with you?
I'm sorry, but I need to speak with you.
Are you sure you can speak right now? I just heard you had a huge loss.
It's more than just a loss, Dean. It's a symphony of a larger problem. A problem that only we have the power to address. You've got to take a look at this.
I knew the losses were bad, but not this bad.
We have to do something.
We? I don't think there's anything we can do about it.
What? The numbers speak for themselves. We're facing a crisis here. The demand of organ transplants far exceeds the supply of organs. People are out there dying while waiting for a chance of life.
I know, but there is really nothing we can do about this.
We could start a campaign. Organ donation is a complex issue influenced by societal, religious, and cultural aspects. Those are the barriers. And maybe if we get over those barriers and eliminate them, then maybe, just maybe, the next John would actually live to witness the birth of his child. Yeah, we need to start a comprehensive awareness program. The one that targets religious institutions, colleges, schools, communities, literally everywhere.
You're a noble man, Doctor. But there's nothing we can do about this.
What is wrong with you?
Every day, over 1 lakh patients languish on transplant wait lists, and 17 die every single day. These are not just numbers. Their families, their peoples, their dreams cut short. It is our duty, not just as doctors, but as human beings. The annual demand for a kidney transplant is about 2 lakh. However, a mere 10,000 transplants are conducted every year. Do the math, Dean. That means there are over 5% and 150,000 Johns who don't get the required help. So many lives lost. So many dreams cut short. So many families destroyed. And you're saying you won't help?
I understand, Doctor. There's nothing I can do about this.
I don't think you understand, Dean. These are people who could actually have a shot at living, a shot at loving, a shot at feeling the touch and embrace of their loved ones. A shot that they don't get to achieve because they couldn't get an organ on time. It's about 80% of the population that are not aware. An awareness program targeting policymakers, medical professionals is all that we need.
If only people could take something as tragic as death and add a silver lining to it. Think about it, Dean. A single deceased organ donor can save up to 8 different lives. 2 kidneys can free up to 2 patients from having to do dialysis treatments. A single liver can be split among 2 patients on the wait list. 2 lungs means that 2 more people get another shot. And a donated heart and pancreas means that 2 patients receive the precious gift of life.
And I understand there are religious stigmas that may prevent people from doing it. But isn't the core of religion love? What is humanity if we don't love each other and are not willing to do everything in our power to help others?
Exactly. And the family gets the body back anyway, so they can perform a burial later.
Yes, exactly. Imagine the impact of your decision. Imagine the lives you could transform, the families you could reunite, and the futures you could transform too. Say yes, Dean, and you'll be saying yes to love, yes to hope, and yes to humanity.
I really want to say yes, but there's nothing I can do. I'm sorry about that, Joe.
What? What exactly is it?
Don't you get it, Doctor? Time is up.
I know we are out of time. We couldn't save John, but there's still a million more. Don't let his death go in vain.
John. I don't think you get it. Your time is up.
What do you mean?
Look around you. Take a good look around you.
You never had an intern. He never existed. You're in trauma. The intern wasn't real, and neither am I. John.